how Disneyland's downtown Disney district has changed due to the pandemic. I'm Chris, this is Yellow Productions. I do travel guides that are fun, informative, entertaining, and today I'm at downtown Disneyland on their reopening day. They've been closed for months, and today is the first day that they're open, and so I'm gonna show you everything that has changed here due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The first thing that has changed is the theme parks are closed. California Adventure is closed. Disneyland is closed. This is the least busy I've ever been standing here between the two theme parks. But as we go through, you'll also see everybody's wearing masks. Mask requirement to come in, and the security screening process to come into Downtown Disney is also all new. There are two entrances open to Downtown Disney. There is one open by the Disneyland Hotel, and there's another one open by Harbor Drive. But either one you come in, the first thing you'll be greeted with is somebody who is going to take your temperature. They are contracted from Hoag Hospital, a local Orange County institution. After passing through the temperature checks, then you'll go through a canine dog check. If you're wearing a bag like mine on your arm, they'll ask you to take it off and hold it as you walk past the canine. After the canine check is then the standard bag check. The bag checkers are behind plexiglass. Then you go through a metal detector. If for some reason you fail the metal detector, well then they'll wand you. When they wand you, they stand behind plexiglass when they do that. On the Disneyland website, they tell you to park in the Simba lot, which is at the intersection of Catella and Disneyland Drive. Parking is free in that lot. Now, when I got here, that lot was full, so I actually parked at the Garden Walk Shopping Center. It's $3 per hour, but there was at least parking, and I came in the Harbor Drive entrance. And so in this walkthrough, I'm gonna show you how Downtown Disney looks, starting at the Harbor Drive entrance, starting at the World of Disney, and then walking down to Earl of Sandwich, which is the other entrance. If you parked over there, we'll just reverse it, and that's how it'll look from the way you come in. It's also worth noting that all the other parking lots are currently closed. Okay, so leaving the theme park area, coming into Downtown Disney, I'm gonna turn the camera around so you can actually see what I see instead of looking at me the whole time. The first thing we see is La Brea Bakery, this restaurant, even though it has a lot of outdoor seating, currently closed. So big change to the World of Disney store is it's so popular, they've implemented a virtual queue. This, which used to be the entrance, is now the exit. And if you want to go into the World of Disney, you have to come just across from this exit to where this guy holds a sign that says end of queue. And over here, they've got some friendly people that you give them your cell phone number, they'll sign you up to get a text, and when it's your turn to go in the World of Disney, you get a second text that says you're ready to go in. Once you get your text, you hop in the Return Here line in front of the World of Disney. One of the friendly cast members will check your name. That's what they use to check that you got the text. Provided your name matches the name on the list, then you're cued to get in the line and head into World of Disney. This line moves pretty quick once you're in it. It took about an hour and a half from the time I signed up to get a spot to go in the World of Disney. And only one person needs to sign up for your whole group. Once you head inside World of Disney, it's nicely air conditioned and not too many people in here. So people are definitely social distancing, which is good. They've got a different set of signs inside World of Disney that remind you of the same things that you saw outside, just in the tall variety in here. The biggest change inside of the World of Disney is they now sell cloth face masks. They are $6 each, or four for $20, limit four per guest. You can see they've got the Yoda mask down here if you want to look just like me or lots of other cool Disney characters. They've got a sizing guide to help you decide which size mask that you want. I'm not sure that you really carry a ruler with you when you come here, but smalls for little kids, mediums are for big kids, and large are for adults like me. Other than that, the rest of the merchandise in the World of Disney is pretty similar to what it usually is. I do want to point out, though, if you've been watching The Mandalorian New Arrival, this just in, they've got Baby Yoda. He's so cute. The likeness, I think, is pretty striking. What do you think? One other thing that's kind of weird about being inside the World of Disney, since all the entrances are closed except one, there's people peering in from the other side wanting to see what's inside. The cashiers are behind plexiglass now. They've got numbers on the floor to number the cash registers. They've got spots in the lines to show you where to stand, and they've also got new signs to let you know that they now accept contactless payment. I'm doing great. How about yourself? And a nice touch, they've also got some hand sanitizer right next to the credit card machine. And in case you're wondering what I got from the World of Disney store, of course, some Winnie the Pooh masks. Why? Winnie the Pooh is awesome, and they're yellow. Out in front of the World of Disney, you'll find a couple carts that are open for food. There's Diggity Dogs and Wetzel's Pretzels. Further down is California Churros. Now, definitely not all of the carts are open. If you want to sign up for a Disney Rewards Visa credit card, you'll have to come back another time. But if you want to wash your hands, they've set up some hand washing stations throughout Downtown Disney, so you can wash your hands outside without having to go into the bathroom. Walking around downtown Disney, you'll see tons of these signs to remind you about your health and safety, to wear a face covering, maintain social distancing, to wash your hands, nose washing hands, coughing or sneezing, cover your mouth, and avoid touching your eyes, nose, or mouth. Also, at the places you might sit, they've got signs here on these bench areas to let you know to sit 6 feet apart. Now, whether people are actually doing that, I'll leave that determination up to you. And apparently this bench area, this has been fenced off. There is no social distancing here because you can't even sit there. They got a bunch of these healthy hands stand here, hand sanitizer things throughout the park, but these leave something to be desired. About half of the ones that I tried to use, I guess, were either empty or out of batteries. Another noticeable thing around the park, they have a lot more cast members standing around to help with social distancing. They call them their social distancing squad. Now, just outside World of Disney, this area is usually where the trams would run to the Mickey and Friends structure. Since that structure is closed, there are no trams. This is kind of turned into the hangout without your mask area. Just next to the tram stop is the Naples Pizzeria restaurant, which is open for outdoor dining. I will point out the only dining currently open in downtown Disney is outdoor dining because Orange County currently has a ban on indoor dining. So if you're gonna eat at downtown Disney, it's gonna be outside right now. Now, while the Naples Pizza restaurant is open, the little fast food Napolini right next to it, currently closed. Just across from the Naples Pizzeria restaurant is Starbucks, which is open. This is one of two Starbucks in downtown Disney. They usually have a big line inside. They hold the line outside. If you're doing mobile order pickup, you'll find that inside. Most of the shops in downtown Disney are open. Sunglass Hut, Curl Surf, Pandora. The really busy ones institute some sort of line where you have to wait outside before you go in. Or in the case of Curl Surf, you enter on one side and exit from the other. Pandora social distancing is no more than one guest per associate in the store at any time. Now, Sephora's one store that had no line. In fact, they had a couple employees outside waving at guests, welcoming to come inside. All of the Disneyland hotels are currently closed, so the entrance to Disney's Grand Californian Hotel is for cast members only. If you want to get some fancy Disney dresses, this shop is open. You'll see a staff member there holding a line outside. Marceline's Confectionery, which is really popular for their caramel or chocolate apples, is another store that's implemented the virtual queue. You sign up here on this side with your phone number if they're busy, and then return to the front. Salt and Straw, which has some really delicious ice cream, allows you to pre-order your items online, and you can also order right here by scanning your QR code. You order from Chow Now, and you can tell them your name, and they'll bring your order right to you. I'd do that instead of standing in this line. Wetzel's Pretzels is open. You can get your pretzel fix. Also has a pretty good line. If you're sensing a theme here, there's lines for almost everything in downtown Disney. But if you come to Disneyland a lot, you're probably used to lines above it. Ballast Point Brewery and Kitchen, not yet open. The Uva Bar with the cool yellow umbrellas is open because it's all outdoor seating. When you wait to be seated, they've got this little plexiglass thing by the host stand. And this is interesting, at the Uva Bar, they've got plexiglass to social distance the employees from the employees, the bartender from the servers. It's associated restaurant Catal, which is up on the second floor up here, not yet open. Right next to that, Sprinkles Cupcakes, currently closed. And The Void, Step Beyond Reality, the VR experience, I understand this is actually permanently closed and will not be coming back at all. You can't get into the World of Disney, but you still want some Disney-themed stuff, you can check out Disney Home. There's no virtual queue here. There is a separate entrance and exit, which of course they're holding a line, but you can get some neat Disney plates, cups, and things like that for your home. The restaurant with the longest line at downtown Disney when I was here with Black Tap, Kraft Burgers, and Shakes. Indoor dining's closed. You order through the window here, which is usually where you order the shakes. And to make room for dining, they used to have a pretty small patio out here, but they've expanded their patio to include the area in front of Splitsville, which was the bowling alley and grill. Bowling and the grill at Splitsville currently closed. As is Tortilla Joe's, right across the way. We've basically come to the closed section of downtown Disney. This little area has a lot of closed things. Also, Ralph Brennan's Jazz Kitchen, the big restaurant, and the Little Express, both currently closed. But if you want to get some really expensive art at the Wonderground Gallery, that is open. Now from Ralph Brennan's Jazz Kitchen, we cross this bridge that most people don't know is a bridge, but it's actually a bridge where one of the roads of Disneyland goes underneath. Here, there's usually a ton of shopping carts. Right now, there are just two on this side that are Sunglass Hut carts and a churro cart. Just next to the monorail, which is currently not running, is the Pin Traders, which is an outdoor stand. Pins are very popular, and so they've implemented a line to wait to see pins as well. Probably another one of the most popular stores here is the Lego store. Lego store line out front that wraps around to the bathroom. But really neat was I was seeing some staff members wiping the handles, wiping the railings. They're doing a really good job keeping Downtown Disney clean and sanitary. When I mentioned they do a good job wiping, they're really wiping everything down. I saw some guy here wiping the map. That is a thing people touch. They often touch the map to be like, hey, look, we're right here. Well, rest assured, it's clean. Oh, and sometimes people say, Chris, it'd be really helpful if you included a map. Well, I started this walk over here. This is where the theme park entrances are. We walked this way, and now we are right here by the monorail, and we're gonna end over here at the Earl of Sandwich. Speaking of the Earl of Sandwich, I think I'm getting hungry, but we're not there yet. There's the second Starbucks here. This one has mobile order pickup outside. This one's less busy than the other one, so if you're looking for Starbucks, I would check this one out. This shop, probably one of the least busy shops, Sugar Boo & Company, dealer in whimsy, just has some whimsical home items. In front of what used to be the Rainforest Cafe is a new Asian street eats eatery. You order at this little stand, and then you pick up your food just over there. They've got a few tables in front of it, but they've also got a whole bunch more tables that are over here in front of what used to be the movie theater. And then the long line that you see here, that's the line to eat at the Earl of Sandwich, which is my favorite restaurant in Downtown Disney. If you're looking for something to eat, I would check out Earl of Sandwich. That's where I ate today. I had a Earl's Club and a holiday turkey sandwich. Yes, I'm a glutton and I got two sandwiches, but I've not eaten here since February, and so I was really hankering for some Earl of Sandwich. Just beyond the Earl of Sandwich, this is the security checkpoint if you parked in the Simba lot next to the Disneyland Hotel, currently closed. What used to be the ESPN Zone or Pop-Up Disney, also currently closed. There's also a Disney stage here where they usually have live music. Currently, no live music. And in case you're wondering how Disneyland closure has affected the rest of the area is super closed, boarded up, hotels are closed, businesses are closed. They're super closed. They put paper in the window to let you know that they are really closed. There is really no life in the Disneyland area other than at Downtown Disney right now. 2 days ago, would be no life anywhere. So with all these changes, you might be wondering to yourself, Chris, is it still fun to go to Downtown Disney? Is it still enjoyable? Well, you know what? Don't listen to me. I ran into a couple of Yellow Productions fans from Washington, D.C., so let's hear from Molly.
Yeah, so it's been a lot of fun so far. Of course, the masks are a little restricting, but it's not too bad. The only thing that was a little disappointing, it's our first time here, so the parks are closed, but being in Downtown Disney is still really fun.
Well, I think Molly said it pretty well. Still pretty fun. Not as fun as if you could actually go into the theme parks, but still an interesting attraction in Southern California. There's one more thing you should know before you come to Downtown Disney. Their hours have changed due to the pandemic. They are currently open from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Some of the shops do close a little earlier. Now, if you're planning a trip to Disneyland once it reopens, you might enjoy watching some of my videos about inside the Disneyland theme park. And actually, since I'm Yoda today, I won't say you might enjoy watching them. I will say these are the videos you're looking for. I will see you over there.